Yo, what up, hey, how you doing, guys? My name is Sanj, and firstly, I'd like to welcome you to my channel. Today, I'm introducing you guys to a new video series called Vintage Vibes, and allow me to explain how it's going to work. As I'm sure you've gathered throughout the other videos, my style is quite all over the place. I don't like to be predictable. I like to mix in some streetwear, I like to mix in some formal wear, and every now and then, see, I'll bust out hats or these long overcoats, like really vintagey vibes. And so, I'm sure you've all seen the Thrift gods, Paul Cantu, Jacob Starr, with their trip to the Thrift. Unfortunately, here in England, we don't have a massive access to thrift stores, or at least not that I know of. There's no huge Goodwills, like the small little charity shops that we have down the roads don't really have much, or at least not around where I live. And so, I usually travel into London to go into stores such as Beyond Retro, Blitz, Rocket, East End Thrift Store. And so I decided to do a new series where every month I'm gonna give myself £50 and go out there and try and find the best of what I can do with this given budget. Obviously, I'd love for like other people to take part in it, so if you like the idea of it, if you have £50 to spare every month, it is potentially an idea for a video. So £50 monthly, the best vintage that I can find around London. Let's go. Okay, so before we crack on with our first pickup, I just want to explain to you how the store works. So it's called East End Thrift Store. It's just off Brick Lane, and it's basically a filler bag concept store. What that means is you get the option of two bags, one that costs £10, which is a medium sized, and then the other one which costs £20, which is slightly larger. And you just get to roam around the shop, fill up the bag, and as long as it closes, as long as it can close at the end of your purchase trip or whatever, you just pay the amount for the bag size, and then you walk away with whatever you've got. So in a £10 bag, you're roughly able to squeeze in two coats, a jumper, and like smaller stuff like t-shirts or scarves or whatever. So for £10, I was able to get this coat, a cardigan, a jacket, and loads of scarves. Obviously, the guy, the sales associate that was helping me out, was being really kind, to be fair. He was really pressing it down inside the bag, and they know what they're doing. So the first piece that I got is this massively long overcoat. Again, I believe this is a women's piece, just because the label reads Elizabeth, a Liz Claiborne company. I'm gonna presume it's a women's. It is huge, it is long. It cuts off really high on the sleeves, which is cool. I mean, you can play around with it. I tend to buy stuff vintage anyway that I like to customize. Don't get me wrong, there are some vintage pieces that are beautiful to wear, but a lot of them I buy, I shred, I take apart, I cut it up just so that I can experiment and then have some sort of do-it-yourself vibe to it. So with this piece, I've taken off the shoulder pads. I tried to add, it's still a work in progress, but I need to customize it a hell of a lot more. To be fair, I've come to the stage now where I kind of don't know whether to keep it or just to give it away. We'll see, it might have some life to it. So that's the first piece. Hopefully you'll get a B-roll. And unfortunately, due to the length of the coat, I wasn't able to get the full body. If my sister comes home from school, then I might get her to film, but I'm unsure about that. So we'll see. On to the next piece. Okay, on to the next piece. I've got a cable knit cardigan. It is a women's cardigan. This is grandma level right now, but it is elongated, and I can play with it with the layering. I do wear it underneath my jackets, coats. It looks sick. The only thing that I might change later on is they have these very small women pocket that I would just tear. Like, you can, the seam isn't that complicated, you can easily just unpick that and then just have it pocketless. It fits really good, I really like the way it fit. Again, from the same place as the coat before, East End Thrift Store. It managed to fit inside the bag that was £10, along with the other coat and a few other stuff. So, yeah. Hopefully, as I said, you'll get some footage as to how it fits. Also, later on, I'm wearing it with a coat so that you can kind of see how it fits underneath a coat. I might throw that in now, most likely to be later on though. So yeah, that is a cable knit cardigan. Okay, third piece, and still from the same place. East End really does provide some absolute bangers. we've got this coat, which is sick. I mean, it's a jacket, sorry. It's a suede jacket. When I found it, it was all crumpled up. That's the thing with these sort of places, especially this one, it's in a warehouse. So, A, all the clothes are just thrown together. Don't get me wrong, they are hanged, but it isn't ideal. As you can see, it was crumpled a lot. It is dirty, it needs a wash. And the smell is like vintage, like really stinking vintage. Not that it matters. Anyway, suede, it has these sort of paisley print to it. I like the fact that it's crumpled. Obviously, once you give this a wash, I don't know if it will retain the crumpled elements, but it looks sick with the paisley, with the flowery sort of print. I did wear it a couple of times. I thought I was going to get a lot more wear out of it, but the smell was just too much for me to handle, and so I am trying to sell it. So if anybody's watching and likes a look at this, obviously hit me up. You've got all my social medias in the description and also floating at the beginning of the video. So if you like the look of this coat, message me and I'll get back to you as to how much you want it for, blah, blah, blah. Eastern Thrift Store, final pickup from there. Beautiful store, definitely worth checking out. It's called East End Thrift Store. And yeah, we're moving on to, I believe, Blitz. Okay, so for the next piece, we're not gonna need the mannequin. I then went to a store called Blitz in Brick Lane. Bearing in mind, at that time, this was the first time I actually went to the store. And it is incredible. I mean, I've read loads of good reviews about it, but legit one of the best vintage stores that I've been to. This was a pair of Calvin Klein Studios trousers. Once again, I believe they were women's wear, but like many have said previously, and I agree to this point. If it fits good, if it looks good, who cares if it's women's or men's? Just buy it, customize it, and make it yours, make it work. And so, these huge baggy ass trousers, basically recently I'm really getting into the whole baggy aspect of it. I think that bagginess is going to come back. Obviously it has to be done tastefully. So these, although they're huge and you'll see them on body, they do taper in at the bottom, and gave them a massive cuff. I took them to my tailor's because this was one of the things I wanted to get it done properly, because I am going to be wearing this a hell of a lot. Well, I have worn it a lot. Looks great with boots, looks great with smart trousers, smart shoes. Fat cuff, tapered, shortened as well. That's what I think with baggy trousers that works. Just shorten them, taper them, and then wear them with boots. A designer that I look up to is Yoji Yamamoto, and do you know that pronunciation? Anyway, and yeah, he does some sick ass baggy clothes, and the way he kind of plays with the proportion looks sick, and he always pairs them up with boots, and so that's kind of where I got that from. A fat cuff also adds a bit of personality to it. I don't know if it's going to auto focus, I highly doubt it, so you'll see it on the on-body portion of this video. So these were the Calvin Klein baggy ask trousers. I'm mumbling all over the place here. And then last but not least, we've got the Showstopper. This is a Harley Davidson biker denim jacket. Now, when I bought it from Blitz, it was just a massive standard denim jacket, blue denim jacket, size XXL. It was just huge, it just kind of draped all over. And I got it for an absolute steal as well, again from that place. And so, I had watched the four or five seconds video from Rihanna, Kanye West, and Paul McCartney, and I'm not gonna lie, I saw their jackets, I was like, that is sick, I need to make one for myself. Now, I didn't want to spend much money on like buying a denim jacket that was already all shredded up and ripped up, and so I decided to make it my own. Went to this place, got this jacket, dirt cheap, and then just started ripping into it, shredding it to pieces. You'll see it on the B-roll. How much detail and work went into it. Then I was like, it's still too big and drapey, so I tapered in at the waist, well, taper in at the whole body, shortened the sleeves, tapered the sleeves. Yeah, did quite a bit of work into this. Changed the silhouette, so I took the waistband and turned it into a belt, so that the bottom is still raw and shredded, but I can kind of play around with the silhouette, so I can either tighten it at the front and have a sort of very V-esque shape, or I could just pull it, I don't know if you can see it there, pull it off, tighten it at the back, and then you get like a really close slim fitting denim jacket. But yeah, just experiment, guys. Like, buy stuff that you wouldn't necessarily wear as it is on the rail. If you know that you can customize it and make it look good. I mean, don't get me wrong, this isn't a piece that I will wear every day, do you know what I mean? It's kind of special, special occasions or whenever I feel like making a statement. But yeah, just play around, experiment. If you have a sewing machine at home, then perfect. If not, then most of it can be done by hand if you are interested in that sort of stuff. But obviously it's gonna take a lot longer. But yeah, guys, that is it in terms of all the stuff that I've picked up. Hope you've enjoyed this video and the series of, I'm kind of playing it safe in the sense that I'm doing it a month in arrears. So I already have the stuff that I've picked up for this month ready for next month, if that makes sense. So technically these were picked up a month ago, but that gives me time to work with the items, like go to the tailors or just start ripping it to shreds. Actually saying that, I have started ripping to shreds another piece that I've picked up for the next month. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the content. I do appreciate all the support, guys. I think I've just reached 100 subscribers. It isn't much, but it's still a lot to me anyway. So I appreciate all the support. Like, share, comment, and subscribe and all that jazz. You can follow me on all social medias. It's all down in the description box down below. Hope you enjoyed, have a beautiful day, and take care. Peace.